Hi, danke fürs Einschalten.
I will record this video in English because this is the mother language, first language of most of you, I think. But it's not mine, and so please excuse any mistakes or misspellings, etc. There will be some of them, I guess. I'll try my best. If I were a journal, what would it be? Whew, I asked myself already many questions about me and myself, but this question was new, is new. And it was a difficult task. I would like to find myself in this journal too. I would. And I had to think of what kind of way, in what kind of way is this possible? So, I chose a special way to allow sorry, allow a fast change of decorations. I always have some embellishments and decorations that I adore. And I was very reluctant to put them into a journal because then they will stick there and not will be not available for other projects, which in which they suits better. Yes, so I decided to add a layer above the cardstock for the cover page, a layer of fabric, and stuffed it with a wedding. I stuffed it with some wedding, and then I laid the upper layer of fabric above it, and resembled the whole cover. And on top, I stitched this last layer of fabric with some special stitches, and this is painted with acrylic paint, so it is a little bit more sturdy. And then I can put some decorations, embellishments with pins on it. These are also pins. This is one bit of low stitching I did. And these buttons are the heritage of my grandmother. My mother gave it to me, and I was always very reluctant to put them on some journals. And then they were gone forever. So I hoarded them. I kind of hoarded them. This brooch, brooch was also of my grandmother. And this is definitely Art Nouveau, and it's so amazing. I like it so much. I like it to be around me, and I like to look at it. And so I put it on my journal. This piece is also antique. I bought it on a flea market. It's some kind of furniture embellishment. This is Tim Holz. These are old pillow slips that I cut into pieces, and I made this little how it's called, dingle dangle gedöns. So, okay, let's start. Inside of my journal, I would like to keep this kind of flexibility. So I decided to put an removable journal in there, held by a rubber band. And this journal contains of pieces of sketching pads. Different sketching pads for different sketching tools. There is aquarelle paper, there is darker paper for sketching, lighter paper for sketching, some paper for alcohol marker. And I use different tools every day, or every time I decide to draw, I even use my iPad, but I like, often I like the good old-fashioned way to draw or to sketch, or to fiddle, footle, doodle, deedle, daddle, and then I have these, I can choose one of these opportunities. This is Tim Holtz with Mod Podge, and the fabric I also bought on a flea market. I don't know if it is antique, but it is delicate, and I always waited for a special moment to work with it, and here it is. You can put the signatures out without slicing these. What do you call strands? Faden? Oh God, I don't know the right word right now. You can tear this open and then you can take this sheets out of it and you can bind some new signatures. And therefore, you can keep this fancy, fabulous fabric. Okay, this is a little folder I crafted out of a bigger office folder. I like to recycle very much. I have quite a lot of the stuff that I use in my crafting is old office gedöns stuff which would go to the sink. And I like to save those things and do other things with this. Okay, what's in here? Here are scraps and other material to decorate, to collage. Some paper I made myself. I started just to made some paper with dried flowers, for example, or with a little bit of glitter or something. Depends on the mood I'm in, and it's a fantastic collaging material. These are dried flowers, petals of flowers I collected this summer, and simply press it with some paper towels in my book press, and it's wonderful. I like to assemble this with watercolor drawings, etc., and I could use it in my journal. Also for collaging, etc., these old book pages, partly covered with some decoupage Serviettentechnik. Serviettes? Is this a real English word? I don't know. Serviettes? No, I don't think so. Anyway, okay, some more goodies. Moment. Here are some pockets made of old book pages, and also other kind of pocket. Open there too. You could use this also in the journals, and these are cardstock with old book pages and fussy cat bugs out of an encyclopedia is it in German it calls lexicon, an old Brockhaus lexicon of 1900. And I found it on the street. And the guy who put it on the street couldn't cope with the amount of books his father had left him. And he decided to put it on the street then for some book lovers to come by and to get it. And I was the lucky one. I copied this. I could not, I wasn't able to tear pages out of it, because I am so in awe of this old books, and some of them I can't destroy. And even if it's to make other things out of them. Oh, this is some fussy cat out of a catalog. And these are some more pictures of this encyclopedia. Oh, whatever. Whatever. Also, fussy cat. Fussy cat? Fussy cat. Genau, fussy cat. So. Ach, ja, okay. Gut. This is made of out of an envelope. So you can see what's inside. Almost. With tea bags. And a little gold. So. And now my little treasure. What would it be called? Treasure chamber? Schatzkammer? I made this out of cardstock. Just glued it together, and then I decide to use this fabric. This is faux leather. This is not a real leather. This is out of an old jacket of my father, and this jacket was one. He loved this jacket, and only a few years ago it was so worn out. I think you would call it worn out, abgenutzt. That my mother decided, oh, he can't wear this any longer, and they don't want it to give it into the trash, and so they give it to me, to make a little something, and I made a bag for my mother out of the jacket, and now I use it for other projects, and I think it would be nice to be. To have a little something with me of my father's jacket. Okay, long story. Inside there are many devices some devices for journaling, for collaging, etc. And some drawing tools, glue, scissor, some clamps. These are Tim Holtz clamps. I adore this. These little tiny treasures. And this is Ito yarn, Japanese yarn. I saw this in a video of an unboxing of a bento box of, how do you spell it? Zora Ashan. I don't know if it's right. I write it down in the notebook. Mumpitz in the show notes or in the info box. Yes, this is Itogan and it's amazing. I use it whenever I can. Some washi tape, and these are my stamps which I crafted is better, I think. I started this a few months ago, and I cannot stop. It's too funny to create those little things, and you can choose your motif, and then you can scribble, and then you can cut it out of this material and pop it on these little cubes, and then you have a stamp, your own stamp. I really like it. So, and therefore, we need stamp pads, ink pads, ink pads, and I use this Tim Holtz ink pads a lot. I think they are gorgeous. And one of the last little features is this pocket I made. I can't open it yet, so with scraps, some scraps for journaling and decorating, etc. This is a stamp I made, and some little doodles on paper, old paper, some old paper from old book, Japanese paper, I like it, I love it. Whatever this is, I don't know for real, but it's really nice. And some old book pages. I always fiddle around this book pages. I like them very much. So, and there are some Pilze, fungus. Genau. I don't know in the moment where these are from. I write this down in the info box. And these are Nick the Booksmith pictures from a little book, from a mini book. And I ironed the paper with beeswax, and so they became translucent, which is very nice. Little pills. This is from the same source which they are from, and I will give the name to you in the info box. So this was my journey. I hope you understood what I say. And I appreciate your Geduld. I don't know the English word yet. I think I have to leave before I say too much strange things now. Thank you all. I hope you enjoyed it. Bye bye.